Hello and welcome to Brighton Lights, the show dedicated to bringing you the very best of what's on in our city. Well, let's see what's happening on the music scene this week. And first up, we have the Ska Vengers, an exciting eight-piece band from New Delhi who blend ska rhythms with elements of dub, punk, jazz and rap. As a result, their music is refreshingly different, energetic and perfect for dancing to. They've won accolades all over the world for their brilliant stage act and are coming to the Brunswick in Hove on Thursday at 8 p.m. as part of their UK tour. Tickets for the gig are just £5.50. Also coming to Brighton this week is Hats Off to Led Zeppelin, the official number one UK tribute to one of the greatest and most influential bands in rock history. This tribute band features some of the finest musicians in the country, who between them have played with the likes of Queen, Ray Davies and Iron Maiden, as well as appearing in countless West End shows. This is the closest you'll get to experiencing the legendary Led Zeppelin music, so don't miss the band's performance at Rope Tackle on Friday at 8 p.m. Tickets are £14, but do book early to avoid disappointment. Next is someone who has been hailed as a messiah of blues rock and a female guitar prodigy. At just 8 years old, Chantel McGregor was the youngest person in the UK to pass a rock school exam. And a few years later, she became the first ever student at Leeds College of Music to achieve a 100% pass mark. Since then, the hugely talented singer-songwriter has won several awards, including the first female to be voted Guitarist of the Year at the British Blues Awards in 2013. You'll hear some of the songs from her second album, Lose Control, when she performs at Comedia on Friday at 7:30. Advance tickets are £14. And the girl power continues with the Priscillas. Formed in 2003, their music combines power pop and glam punk rock, and the girls have gained a reputation for their incredible live performances. They're known for storming around the stage as if they own it. Also joining them is the Brighton-based alternative rock band Mum, Dad and the Kids, who have played a dark and intelligent kind of pop music and are widely regarded as one of the city's best live acts. See both of these groups on Friday at the Prince Albert. The performance kicks off at 7:30 and advance tickets are £5. Also this week sees the return of the fourth Undercover Festival. This popular two-day event is packed full of the finest alternative music, from punk and ska to dub and reggae, all performed by the best local and national acts. This year's headline acts include The Selector, Dreadzone and Eddie and the Hot Rods, not to mention an exceptional supporting lineup. You don't even need to worry about bad weather, as every stage is indoors. The festival takes place on Friday and Saturday at Brighton Racecourse. It's going to be a great weekend with more stages and bands than ever before, so get your tickets today for £40. And don't forget that auditions for the Open Mic UK Brighton Music Competition are coming to the Old Market on Sunday. This competition is the biggest search for unsigned acts in the country, and if you make it through to the live shows, you'll perform at some of the best music venues in the UK. The competition is open to anyone, so if you're a singer, rapper or vocal group and think you've got what it takes, check out their website to enter. Well, let's have a look at what's happening on the theatre scene now. We're starting off with a mention for Kerry McLean from Brighton. She's an actress, director and sound designer who is one of four finalists in this year's Theatre Madness Festival in London, which is a launching pad for emerging writer-directors. Kerry has worked on scores of successful productions and set up the Brighton-based theatre company Roll Mop Arts in 2006. She and three other finalists will have to write and direct a 10-minute play inspired by a single word. So if you'd like to support Kerry, go and see the performances at the Stratford Circus Arts Centre on Saturday the 10th of September. Doors open at 6:30 and general tickets are £10. Back in Brighton now, and there are still tickets available for Relatively Speaking, Alan Ayckbourn's brilliant comedy of misunderstandings and mistaken identity. The story chronicles the increasingly complicated and hilarious situation that unfolds when a man, intent on asking the parents of his dream girl for her hand in marriage, inadvertently approaches the wrong couple. Starring Robert Powell and Lisa Goddard, this production is ingeniously crafted and guarantees an evening of continuous laughter. It's at the Theatre Royal until Saturday, and general tickets start at around £16. Also this week, 88 London Road set sail to the Brighton Open Air Theatre with their new production of Treasure Island. This classic pirate tale by Robert Louis Stevenson is filled to the brim with swashbuckling and promises to be an epic, all-singing, all-dancing adventure. It's perfect for the whole family, so make sure you catch one of the performances at the Brighton Open Air Theatre between tomorrow and Sunday the 18th of September. The shows are at 7pm with matinees at weekends, and tickets are £15 or £12 for concessions. Now, for an interactive theatre production, see Every Brilliant Thing. This one-man show is a journey through the mind of a six-year-old who makes a list of everything that's brilliant and worth living for in the world. Although this is essentially a story about depression, critics reckon it's one of the funniest plays you'll ever see. Following an acclaimed run at the Edinburgh Fringe and in New York, the show makes its Worthing debut next Friday the 9th of September at the Denton. The performance is at 8pm and tickets are £14. And tickets are flying out the door for The Magic of Motown. This stylish new show is coming to Brighton next month as part of a nationwide tour to celebrate its 10th birthday and the 50th anniversary of the chart-topping single Reach Out, I'll Be There. It's a sensational concert with a huge cast, reviving more than 36 of the best Motown classics from legendary artists like The Supremes, The Temptations, Stevie Wonder, Diana Ross, Marvin Gaye, and The Jackson 5. With glittering costumes and dazzling dancing, this is a real theatrical treat that will have you on your feet from start to finish. See it at the Theatre Royal on Saturday the 22nd of October at 7:30. Tickets start from around £20. You'll definitely be dancing on the ceiling with that one. Well, let's look now at some of the movies showing locally this week. Now, 10 years ago, the BAFTA-winning writer and director Noel Clarke introduced us to the harsh world of Sam Peel and his disillusioned teenage friends in the British drama film Kidulthood. The third and final instalment of Noel's acclaimed Hood series, Brotherhood, is currently in cinemas. Sam now has a family of his own, but it isn't long before his past catches up with him and he is forced to confront new dangers and challenges. Like its predecessors, Brotherhood offers a gritty, fast-paced and strikingly realistic look at British inner-city life. Our next film is set in ancient Japan. Kubo and the Two Strings is the epic story of a young boy who accidentally summons a vengeful spirit from the past and must embark on a quest to save his family and solve the mystery of his father, the world's greatest samurai warrior. The praise for this dazzling animation has been phenomenal. It's yet another huge success for stop-motion giants Laika, combining effective thrills and scares with humour, sadness and a stunning score. It's nothing short of magical and will appeal to all ages, so do see it in cinemas on Friday. Also out on Friday is Captain Fantastic. Viggo Mortensen plays an overprotective father who has dedicated his life to raising his six children in a remote forest, as far from civilization as possible. But when tragedy strikes, the family is forced to abandon their isolated existence and enter the wider world for the very first time. Matt Ross's award-winning drama is a rare movie that raises some big questions about parenting, family, and modern-day America. It's original and unpredictable, with gorgeous visuals and strong cast performances. This Friday also sees the release of Ben-Hur, a spectacular reimagining of Lew Wallace's historical action epic. This tale of revenge and forgiveness centres around Judah Ben-Hur, a prince who returns to his homeland to seek revenge after being falsely accused of treason and forced into years of slavery. The film was shot in some beautiful Italian locations and offers plenty of bold action and spectacle, not to mention a breathtaking chariot race. And hold your breath for the standout horror flick of this year. Don't Breathe follows a trio of reckless young thieves who break into the secluded house of a wealthy blind man, believing they'll get away with the perfect crime. Once inside, the intruders discover that their victim is not as helpless as he seems. The film is a claustrophobic addition to the home invasion genre, ratcheting up the tension and dread with sparse dialogue and effective editing and sound design. If you're brave, have a look at this. That's also out on Friday. Time for a quick break now, but in part two, we'll be looking at the latest comedy gigs, local events, and gaming and technology news. Hello and welcome back to Brighton Lights. Before the break, we looked at the fantastic range of music gigs, theatre shows, and new film releases that you can enjoy in and around Brighton over the next few days. So now let's take a look at what's new on the comedy scene. First is a group of unique comedians who are joining forces to raise funds for Médecins Sans Frontières, the humanitarian organisation that delivers emergency aid and healthcare to people affected by conflict and disasters. The lineup includes the hysterically funny David Mills, the sassy Samina Zera, comedy actress Jessica Fosterque, and the charming storyteller Rosie Wilby. The evening is hosted by the wickedly talented stand-up comedian Sammy Stone, so you're guaranteed a lot of fun. This is at Rope Tackle on Saturday evening at 8:15. Advance tickets are £14 and it's for a great cause, so do go and show your support. And that's not the only funny event for charity this week. After the huge success of Comedia's previous cardiac comedy evenings, the fourth instalment of their British Heart Foundation Comedy Night is back with the biggest and best lineup yet. This year's event will see some of the UK's finest comics take to the stage, including Phil Gerrard, Sam Savage, Aidan Goatley, and special guest headliner Ramesh Ranganathan. Of course, the lineup wouldn't be complete without heart surgery survivor Dave Blood as compere. So far, an amazing £6,500 has been raised through cardiac comedy, so it really is a fantastic way of supporting the UK's number one heart charity. Join in the fun at Comedia on Wednesday the 14th of September. The show starts at 8 p.m. and tickets are £17.50. Comedia is also hosting the one-off special event Lolbox, Brighton's brand new comedy show. This is in aid of Raleigh International, a sustainable development charity that works in remote rural areas to improve access to safe water and sanitation. The Michaels family, who have starred in the popular reality show Gogglebox, have brought together the best of Brighton and London comedians for an exclusive night of goggling and giggling. It's a cracking lineup, so don't miss out. This takes place on Thursday the 15th of September at 8 p.m. It's for over 18s only and advance tickets are £8. If it's British political humour that you enjoy, see the comedian and activist Chris Coltrane, who is coming to Brighton with his brand new solo stand-up show, Socialist Fun Times. The ever-optimistic Chris tackles subjects like austerity, tax dodgers, and even dodgier politicians, and appeals to fans of sharp satire and intelligent nonsense. You're guaranteed a hilarious and uplifting evening, and you might even be inspired. See him perform at the Carolina Brunswick Pub on Thursday the 15th of September at 7:45. Tickets are just £4.40. Now, she's a comedian, broadcaster, TV presenter and writer who's best known for her double act with Mel Gedroych and for that BBC One programme All About Cake. Sue Perkins comes to Brighton this weekend for an evening filled with brilliant wit, hilarious stories, a user's guide to Mary Berry and the best bits from her best-selling memoir, Spectacles. There are still seats available for her show at the Brighton Dome's Concert Hall on Saturday at 7:30. Tickets are £25.50, which includes a copy of Sue's new book. She'll also be signing copies after the show. And don't forget that Brighton's alternative comedy night, Jape Culture, comes to Sticky Mike's Frog Bar on Monday the 12th of September. The show starts at 8 p.m. and features a great lineup of London and Brighton acts. Time now for a look at some of the festivals and other events happening in Brighton this week. Firstly, don't forget that this month is your last chance to find out about Dorian Friends. This special event at the Sea Life Centre, in celebration of the release of Finding Dory, has been extended due to popular demand and gives you the chance to set off on an interactive trail and learn all about the blue tangs and clownfish like Disney's Dory and Nemo. This makes for a fantastic family day out, so do dive in and experience it for yourself. And if you enter their free prize draw before midnight on Sunday, you could be in with a chance of winning a family holiday to Sydney. The Sea Life Centre website has the details. Also this week, the fourth Sussex Ukulele Festival comes to Shoreham. As with previous years, the emphasis is on participation, with plenty of workshops, jams and collaborations between players of all ages and abilities. Headlining this year's festival is the international ukulele star, Sarah Spade, who will be performing her trademark vintage swing songs, as well as leading one of the workshops. Other special guests include the Richwoods, Scandamando and the Portslade Ukulele Conservatoire. The event is at Rope Tackle on Sunday and the music will kick off just before midday. It's free entry, but donations are very welcome. Now, this week's Undercover Festival isn't the only event celebrating alternative music. We also have the Brighton Alternative Jazz Festival, which launched last year. This is the UK's newest and most daring music event, offering a real alternative to mainstream festivals by showcasing a range of experimental jazz and imaginative improvisation. This year's fantastic lineup features some of the most creative avant-garde jazz musicians from all over the world. The festival will also include several UK debut performances, special collaborations and spontaneous live painting by Gina Southgate. This is all happening at the Old Market in Hove at the weekend. See online for ticket prices. Now, since the advent of Scalarama in 2011, September has become the month of cinema. This nationwide DIY celebration of cinema sees the hundreds of venues, film clubs, organisations and cinema enthusiasts come together to celebrate the wonderful world of film. The idea behind Scalarama is for passionate film fans to meet and share resources and to bring excitement to communal film watching for a whole new generation. As part of the festival, Dukes at Comedia is screening Psychomania this Saturday night, a shining oddity of 70s cinema about a gang of undead bikers. Also this Saturday, the Duke of York's is screening Out of Print, a documentary about the film industry's transition between formats, followed by a Q&A session. You've got the whole month to make the most of this festival, and anyone is welcome to put on a screening, so do check out the Scalarama website for more details. And if you're a sports enthusiast, this is a great weekend to be in Brighton. A new and free sport and fitness show comes to Hove Lawns on Saturday and Sunday, offering a huge range of sports-related experiences and stalls. Taking place alongside this event on Sunday is the Brighton and Hove Triathlon, a thrilling race along the city's coast. It's going to be an action-packed weekend, so make sure you get involved. Well, let's look now at what's happening in the world of gaming and technology. And what better way to start than with Brighton's very own digital festival? This fascinating four-week celebration of digital culture returned at the start of this month with another diverse programme of events, one of which is Slave to Mortal Rage. This is a quadraphonic virtual reality installation which combines HTC Vive room scale and games engine technology, allowing you to explore, interact and uncover a story in which you are the central character. Tomorrow is your last chance to try this immersive multi-sensory experience for yourself. It's at the Old Market in Hove and tickets are just £5. Elsewhere, a nine-piece group of young musicians is pushing the limits of live music technology. Electric Youth Ensemble is the first group of its kind in the UK, aiming to showcase the potential of digital technology and software in producing, writing and performing music. They are presenting Visions of the Future, a work combining voice, flute and electric guitar with cutting-edge sampling, live drums and analogue synthesis. It's at the Old Market on Sunday at 7 p.m. Tickets are £5. There are also some brilliant digital events for children. For example, Maker Club is running a free taster session where you can learn how to build your own robots and play with some of the incredible equipment like 3D printers and laser cutters. So if you're Minecraft mad or a budding inventor, make sure you head over to Barclays Eagle Labs in Brighton on Thursday between 5 and 8 p.m. There's only limited space though, so do book early to avoid disappointment. Another event that's part of the Brighton Digital Festival is the Future of the Workplace. You'll hear from four experts on virtual and augmented reality, artificial intelligence, the Internet of Things, and 3D printing, and the ways in which these new technologies are changing the way we work. You'll also be able to try out some virtual reality headsets and augmented reality apps. This is at Comedia tomorrow at 5 p.m. Tickets are £15. And one of the latest game releases to utilise new technology is Deus Ex, Mankind Divided. This cyberpunk-themed video game is set 2 years after Human Revolution and sees the return of Adam Jensen as he attempts to uncover another conspiracy. It combines elements of first-person shooters with a role-playing upgrade system and dialogue trees, and players can tackle situations using combat, hacking, stealth and social interactions. The game took the top spot on the UK sales chart at the end of August, receiving praise for its fantastic world-building and side missions and its more diverse options for completion. And this wouldn't be gaming news without mentioning the phenomenon that is Pokemon Go. Now, the game has actually seen a considerable drop in login figures, mainly due to lack of updates and new features. But Pokemon Go is still pulling in around 30 million users and remains the top downloaded mobile game of all time. Niantic recently announced a new Buddy Pokemon feature, which allows you to become best friends with your favorite pocket monster. You'll also be able to develop a virtual friendship with it, leading to unique rewards and experiences. So perhaps this new feature will lead to another surge in the game's popularity. So there's lots going on as usual in the virtual world. And that's it for Brighton Lights this week, but do join me again next time for another roundup of the best entertainment on offer in our city.